Good evening. This is Chandra Gandhapadhyay. Microsoft Azure Administrator. I'm going to show you a demo of Office 3 Microsoft Azure portal. Now this is what subscription you are doing. Actually, you are purchasing a subscription of Microsoft Azure from this thing. After purchasing the subscription, once you log in into the portal, now this is how the portal will look like to you. Now this is a detail of portal. What do you see in a home? This is what you see in a home exactly. This is about all about Microsoft Azure details. Here you will find the features. Here you will find the pricing. Here you will find the documentation. Here you will find the downloads, whatever downloads are there. This is a marketplace from where you can purchase a application for Microsoft Azure. This is a blog. There's a community of Microsoft Azure, and this is support division of Microsoft. So this, all these things you will see in the Microsoft home. Now we'll return back to port. This is how the you can see this is a subscription. This is Azure Pass is a solution, which is subscription which I am using. You can have many other subscriptions. Now you can see the subscription. Is a subscription is basically you are purchasing the subscription of Microsoft Azure for various services which is provided by Microsoft. And this, you can add multiple subscription also in this. I'll now go to that. Here you will find the pricing of all the Microsoft services which is coming in this. Here you will find the documentation, here downloads, community, support, accounts. This is about all about your accounts. What is your account? This is the ID you can see. This is the main account ID. This is by which I am able to manage the whole Microsoft Azure cloud. Okay. This is prior. Do not change this. This will be going to start charging you. So please do not change this. Go to portal. Now what you can see, a marketplace, profile and preview features. These are the new features which is added by the Microsoft in their portal. This is the profile which you will see by clicking. Profile is just like a normal profile. So it says who is the owner of this subscription, Chandrakantupade, and my email ID is this. The address we have in office. On file is .in, your company name is this. By this is the name why I have registered this subscription. While subscribing the subscription, you have to enter your name, your company detail, your company address and all those things that you can enter here. So this will be going to reflect when you click on a profile, who is the owner and who is the main subscription holder and what is this company's name. This you will find marketplace. A marketplace, since I have not purchased anything, this is a trial version which I am using. So it says me, actually I have not purchased only. So if I'll click on purchase, and if I'll purchase anything, then only it will give me. Say if I'll click here, so I can purchase services from the Microsoft, then there it will be showing you. Now here it is, these are the services Microsoft is providing. This is your actual Azure portal, Microsoft Azure portal. I'll click this. First we will see simplicity. First we will try to understand the portal of Microsoft Azure. I'll be clicking here. By default, when you log in into this, here it is showing you the credit status. Say for example, I have 13 days of credits. How I can see? If I click this, it will tell me details of my subscription. What type of subscription I have, if I wanted to see that. This is the subscription which I have taken from Microsoft. I have taken only this. This is the overview. It is showing 6100 rupees is given to me as to total 4192 rupees 92 paisa is still there. Pricing calculators are there. See here, you will find a lot of services. This is all services, data transfer, when the data will be transferred from Microsoft Cloud to your on-premise. That exactly it is showing data transfer in, data transfer in GB, right? This is two different zone. What is a zone? Zone is a basically a place where you are putting your all the from the where you are taking the services, right? In case if you are taking storage services, computer services or networking services, so all these services are coming from one zone, and this zone is nothing but your country wise it is called as also a zone, is also called as Singapore, say Australia and other places where the data center is there, and where in data center you have taking these services from which data center. So that it is showing you. This is all billing. You are responsible for how much data you have sent, consumed. This is a consumption of data. Data transfer out. What data is coming out from zone 1? What data is coming out from zone 2? Well, how many data you have transferred in? How many data you have transferred in? And this is storage transaction it is showing. How many transactions is happening in the storage? This is free application services which you are using. And this is standard IO package which you are charged. That is, I am charged for 14 rupees 90 paisa. And computer hours, how much? 197 hours. For that, I have been charged 1000. How? It is VM. Which VM virtual machine I have created. Because of that, I am charged this much. Right, first try to understand the screen of this. Exactly, the highest cost is charges in this. If you see standard D1 VM, the one virtual machine, if you use it, created once, it will be charged per day, per hour it is charging. See, for 197 hours, 83 by time, this much is charges there. If you wanted to know the price, you can go to the pricing here. You can go to the pricing. Here you will find the pricing exactly. Whenever we are subscribing this, after 500 rupees of dollars of money which we have subscribed, these are the services which is available from the Azure. Now the charges for these services are these. Now as I told you, cloud, I have explained you what is a cloud computing, what are the IaaS, PaaS, SaaS services. So this is one of the application services. Now the Microsoft Azure is providing two type of services, is PaaS and IaaS. Now app services is nothing but your, or as well as one SaaS, software as a services also. So this is application services, this is infrastructure, that is IaaS. This is again application services, mobile services, another. This is PaaS services. This is PaaS services. This is PaaS services. So this is IaaS. This is PaaS. This is PaaS. This is PaaS. And this is, you can say, call it as a SaaS applications. Right? You can call it as, but it is not the. This is also, you can call it as a infrastructure services. Here you will find what services are there in this. Bandwidth. Support and this is the shared services from your data center you are getting, right? This is the services you have subscribed. If you say wanted to say you wanted to create a multiple site in Office 365, sorry, in Microsoft Azure, just increase. See the amount of site, four site you are creating, standard four site. What is the site of one costing? 581 rupees 17 paisa, right? 581 rupees 17 paisa, 0.79 rupees paisa per hour it is going to cost you. And this is the monthly cost it is showing you. This is monthly cost of one site. This is monthly cost of two sites. So monthly cost. In case if you don't want my this services, If you don't want to, I mean, install the site, or you can stop the sites and these charges will be removed. So this is flexible. Whenever you want, you can put the sites on, you can put the sites on and you can remove the sites. There are various type of services. This is a free services where you don't find a single website will be available to you. You can host the application in website, but there is no website available directly to you. Here in this, you will be getting a website. Here you get the one more thing beside the site. Here what you are getting is a machine. This is what I am telling you about machine. See, this is a virtual machine you are getting. B1, B2, B3, T type of machines are available. And this is the bandwidth which will be used. How many bandwidths you are using? This is maximum data in a month you can download and upload. So bandwidth is this. For 176 GB, you have to download this. Support, not available in this. In a basic application, it's basically nothing but application services, which is actually supporting in various type of applications. You can see what type of applications are there. Tools, right? This is one of the solution that brings together the tools need for building enterprise grade web and mobile application around common development. And this you can choose from a rich employment tree. This, all these things are there. So this is basically bandwidth. How much it will be going to support is not there in this, and there's no website. You can put this now web application straight away into this site, right? And bandwidth will be given to you. This is the rate at which bandwidth will be charged, and this is no support.